BJ Mafia was popping. Trent Baalke and the Jaguars front office just made an absolute huge blockbuster trade with the Minnesota Vikings, and it's not for Danielle Hunter. Pump the brakes. It's for interior offensive lineman Ezra Cleveland. Now, before I actually go ahead and talk about Ezra Cleveland and what this move does for the Jaguars, if you guys please could, go ahead and drop me a thumbs up. It takes 1 second and it helps me and the channel out tremendously. If you guys are new here, consider hitting that subscribe bell to stay tuned for more Jaguars content that I do here on YouTube. And I'm almost at 5K. Please help me get there today. And also, Jags fans, if you guys please could, go ahead and follow me on my socials, especially on Twitter. I'm very active and I'm on there every single day. Jags fans, let's actually talk about this move for the Jaguars. The Jaguars give up in exchange for Cleveland a 6th round pick. And Trent Baalke, this Jaguars front office, does a great job of bolstering this offensive line. Doug Peterson said today on the Pat McAfee show, as the trade had been released by Ian Rappaport, Adam Schefter, and other NFL insiders, he said that this move is for depth purposes. So I'm going to assume when the Jaguars have had a lot of interchangeable pieces on the offensive line so far this season, you obviously had Cam Robinson coming back off of injury. You've had Luke Fortner, who's not played that great. Ben Bartsch has not played that great. Brandon Scherff has dealt with some injuries. There's been a lot of moving pieces on that offensive line. As of right now, for Doug Peterson's words, this is for depth purposes. My assumption is going to be you're still going to have Cam Robinson at left tackle and Anton Harrison at right tackle. And Anton did a phenomenal job on TJ Watt on the island this weekend. I expect him to continue to only get better. Now with the interior of the offensive line, this is where it gets tricky. The assumption for me is going to still be Walker Little at left guard, probably Tyler Shatley or Luke Fortner. But for right now, I'll say Luke Fortner, who's not played good this season. And obviously the leader of that offensive line, Brandon Scherff, at right guard. So that means that you're potentially going to have a Tyler Shatley and a Ezra Cleveland now coming off of the bench, and he's dealing with a little bit of a foot injury. I assume after the bye week, he'll be good to go. So this Jaguars team has depth on the offensive line. Now I think that's exceptionally important. And let's actually take a look at what Cleveland has done so far for the Minnesota Vikings this season. According to PFF, in 248 pass blocking snaps, he's only allowed 10 pressures and 1 sack. And Cleveland is a former 2nd round pick back in 2020. And like I said, he's going to help bolster up this offensive line. I'm not sure if he's just going to be the back half of the season a rental, or if the Jaguars decide that they want to pay him. But I just know that the Jaguars interior of the offensive line needs to be better. And this is a move that does make this team better. It does make the offense a lot better. There's a lot more stability on that offensive line. The most important thing at the very end of the day, even though we all wanted a pass rusher, is protecting number 16, the prince that was promised back there in the pocket. That's the most important thing at the very end of the day. And I like this move for the Jaguars. It's a very low risk, high reward type of situation. Obviously, we saw Montez Sweat get traded for a 2nd round pick to the Bears. We saw Chase Young get traded for a 3rd round pick to the 49ers. And look, those are soul crushing. Those ones hurt. You want to go ahead and trade for a Montez Sweat, a Chase Young, a Danielle Hunter, a Brian Burns. The list goes on. There's so many players that you would love the Jaguars to go out there and get. But honestly, I like this move for the Jaguars. They're showing that they're still buyers at the deadline. They're not going to settle. You protect the interior of the offensive line. You protect your franchise quarterback. You help bolster up this offensive line. And you give the Jaguars a lot better offensive line just moving forward. I like this move. It's not game-breaking. It's not season-changing. It's not going to absolutely change the direction of this team in the immediate future or in the long-term future. But as of right now, it's a simple, smart, safe move. And the Jaguars get a nice interior offensive lineman who's got a lot of upside at a very young age. Jags fans, I want to hear your guys' thoughts in the comments down below. What did you guys make about this move? And who is somebody that you actually wanted the Jaguars to go out there and acquire? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. But Jags fans, that's it for this video. Thank you guys again for sticking around throughout the whole video. Brett James, aka BJ, I'm out, y'all. Go Jags, baby. Peace.